Hey everyone, it's Bailshot back at it with Awaken Chaos here video, and today I'm going to be going over the December 29th patch notes real quick. Now, let's go ahead and jump right into it. So, game updates. I went over this once real quickly, and it looks like all of this is pretty much bug fixes, so I'm not going to go really in-depth in that. It's really just like basic things like damage isn't calculated correctly, like your friends lists are going to be popping up when there's reset accounts. One thing that I did want to note though, and it's actually going to affect my my team. So the comment fixed an issue where the AI targeted probability of Mathasia's healing skills would be selected incorrectly. So I'm not sure if this will change Mathasia's AI, especially for my Queen 12 team, if it will make it easier for me to complete because they'll use the healing skills properly. I'm not sure. All the other ones are basic fixes and bugs. This one's an AI thing with Mathasia. So we'll see how much that changes. But let's go ahead and head into the actual updates. Added festival, winter festival packs. These are just cool packs if you're a spender. I assume they're going to be pretty high value. If you want me to go over them, be sure to let me know in the comments. And then we have two, improve the gear rating, drop from Arcane Dominator, increase the drop rate of 5-star gear in Stage 10. Stage 11 will drop only 5. Wow. So I only skimmed through this and I didn't read this last part. Stage 11 only dropping 5 and 6-star gear makes farming Stage 11 extremely, extremely viable. I myself was stuck on Stage 11 of Tulpa. I didn't want to farm it because I'm like, okay, if I get a 4-star piece, you're not going to use it. Especially if you're trying to tackle Stage 12, you really need 5 and 6-star pieces. So if you happen to get a 4-star legendary piece, that feels really bad because you just sell it or you enhance it into another thing. So this is huge. Actually, this is a big free-to-play change for a lot of people out there. Really insane, actually. Arcane Dominator reduced the speed and resistance of the Queen of the Tides from 4-star to 12. Another nerfed Queen. I don't think it was super necessary. This doesn't really change my team that much. For those of you that haven't seen, I use a very free-to-play team. You can use, I'm not going to go over the whole team comp here because I'm going to have a video on it soon in depth. But this will help like standard teams, with Zatlux and such. This, my team was a more slow, controlled one. Reducing the resistance could help lower the gear requirement for Santis, for example, but I don't think it changes too much. It's a decent free-to-play friendly change, and it will help a lot of people out there. Just to the challenge quest from Clear Endless Trials level 50 to Clear Endless Trials. Okay, so this is just a nice quality of life. There was a challenge quest where you were getting far and you were probably on Endless Trials level 70, but then they required you to clear level 50. So now you can just clear level 70 and be fine. That's cool. Reduce the damage dealt by lightning effect in the arena. All offensive heroes will receive 10% once at the start of each round after 7 rounds. Damage skills by... This is pretty big. This is pretty big. Right now, if you're in high platinum, diamond, in my list, I have like people like Vayne 7, I have Etup, I have Arapis, I have Rylan, like all those people are in my arena and they all have tank comps except for Vayne 7. They have a standard, Windstrux comp, but the other ones are pure tank, like Brand, Mathasia, Yolanda, Blackhorn, things like that. It's like so difficult because the tower just kills you before you can actually kill the enemy team. You might actually have the damage to go through them, but you're not going to go through them before 6 rounds. Oftentimes, a lot of other people can get through them. Myself, I cannot get through them. I avoid them like the plague. So this could change things quite a bit. It could make defensive comps much more, tuned down. So we'll have to see. I'll let you know if I, end up experiencing a much big difference in one of my progression account videos. So we'll see. And then optimize. Okay, so this is just like another lightning effect change. So this is pretty big. This change right here is perhaps the most important change, along with the stamina change, since the launch of the game, along with all the events, of course, and such. But the fundamental way this changes the game, along with the mythic farming change. So before you used to farm mythic for your epic gear, now you can get to stage 11, probably from farming mythic with 6-stars and such, and then farm 5 and 6-star gear in order for you to get enough that gear requirement to get to that stage 12 and allow you to farm those really, really excellent pieces. Because as I said, doing stage 11 and getting a 4-star piece was just miserable. So really exciting change. Honestly, I personally am really enjoying the direction this game is going. It seems like people were complaining about a lot of things in the dungeons, and I feel like every change in this specific game update is exactly what everyone was asking for. People wanted to see less tank comps in arena. Okay, they're going to change the lightning effect. They wanted to see dungeons being more useful and being able to farm those early stage. Okay, they did that. They're adding winter festival packs, getting, perhaps you could say that's monetization, but I'd argue that these packs right here are probably some of the best value in the game. So if you are a spender, those are really nice value. They're reducing the speed and resistance because Queen was too hard, some people were saying, and not free to play friendly. Okay, they're doing that. They're doing quality of life changes. All of these updates right here are pure, like, positive for the game. I don't really see a negative here. If you think there's a negative here in the comments, please let me know. But I really don't see a negative here, and I'm really excited. So that'll be it, and I'll see you for the next video.